So with the recent release of the Diamond Casino and Resort DLC, we now have one more property that we can buy and sleep inside. Invite some friends, relax, do stuff. This is just one of many that you can buy in GTA Online, so I thought it'd be necessary to do a list of the worst up to the best properties that you can buy in GTA Online, ranked in order of usefulness regarding how much money they can make, how useful they are, their features, as well as all of the other little nitbits that may or may not attract buyers, so let's get started. Alright, so starting from the worst, we have the yachts. While these things are admittedly pretty cool to have, they ultimately don't really do that much for you. They can act as a sort of landing pad out at sea, you can use it as a mobile safe house that can travel around the map, and even comes with a helicopter,
with the purchase of all applicable upgrades.
But that's pretty much it. A yacht is just an undrivable vehicle that just floats around doing nothing but pollute in the view of the sea. Alright, so I rank these higher than the yachts, mainly because they are far cheaper for one, but they also come with the same things that you get with a yacht. A safe spot, a bed, a TV. It doesn't come with a helicopter, but it comes with something more important. A garage. With said garage, you can store an Oppressor Mark II, which is infinitely more useful than a helicopter in my opinion. These are like two car garages, but they let you hold
three
times more vehicles. These are like two car garages, but they let you hold
five
times more vehicles. Alright, I wasn't really sure where to put Smuggler's Run hangars on this list, to be honest, but I can imagine some people find them more useful than others, but personally, I think because of the existence of the Oppressor Mark II, a Smuggler's Run hangar's usefulness is kind of questionable to me. Why buy expensive aircraft when you can just buy a hovercycle, which is more versatile, has the best missiles in the game, can be spawned in instantly if you have the right privileges, and can be stored inside any land vehicle's storage space? I mean, what is that? Like three vehicles in one, you just can't beat that. The reason I'm putting this higher than the standard 2, 6, and 10 garage houses is because people like to fly. Flying is cool, and the only way you can really collect planes is to have a Smuggler's Run hangar. And here comes the penthouse, which is currently the latest kind of buyable property as of the making of this video. With the penthouse, you have access to a 10 car garage, a massive penthouse that's like the closest thing that you'll get to a mansion in GTA Online, some video games, some creepy weirdos that'll do your hair for you, some luxury bars. Okay, to be honest, there isn't really that much that's useful that you get with the purchase of a penthouse except for being able to fast travel and spawn in some special vehicles by the desk here. And it also sucks if you live in a country that the gambling DLC is disabled for you for legal reasons, so then you don't have the casino that you can just walk right in and have some fun. That is if you're into gambling at all. Okay, so now this is the part where I start getting into the good properties, the things that you may very well want to invest in. But the least best, I would have to say, is the motorcycle clubhouse. When you get one of these, you'll have access to a 10 bike garage location, the ability to spawn in any motorcycle, including the Oppressor Mark II, right in front of you instantly, for free, without cooldown. This in itself is a pretty good reason to buy a motorcycle clubhouse, but not only that, you get your own private shop, which admittedly isn't really that much of a deal maker, but you also get the ability to start off making some money in the form of the motorcycle club businesses, which if you're tolerant enough to put up with Long John Teabag over here, then you can make some pretty serious cash
with the purchase of all applicable upgrades.
While the Arena Wars game mode itself was deemed to be rather lackluster, the Arena Workshop itself is actually pretty sweet, with the ability to store 30 vehicles in just one property,
with the purchase of all applicable upgrades,
a remote control car that you can obtain and customize, as well as an in-house workshop for any kind of personal land vehicle. The Arena Workshop is a great choice if you're looking around for an effective method for keeping a lot of cars and being able to customize them all in one package. Not to mention, if you actually want to play a fun game mode regardless of pay, then you have one right there. While the bunker being this high up in the list may seem questionable to some of you, I personally think that gaining the ability to shoot special kinds of ammo out of your sniper rifles to be a pretty darn cool feature.
With the purchase of all applicable upgrades.
Not to mention, you get all these special vehicles with their powerful mounted weapons, vehicle mines, the AA trailer, which in itself is pretty awesome, but then there's the mobile operations center, which acts as a sort of hub for all of your vehicle and weapon upgrades, and oh, it's a pretty powerful land vehicle in itself that'll destroy most tanks, and even act as a portable garage if you want to conceal a secret weapon in the middle of town. It's a very versatile thing. But you know what's even better? Having an MOC that can fly, is more defensive, and is based off one of the coolest looking aircraft on Earth. With a facility, you can get your very own Osprey that'll chew up any oppressor Mark II foolish enough to come after you, and will pretty much just destroy anything that exists. Except for a satellite that sends down MOABs, which you also get with the purchase of a facility.
With the purchase of all applicable upgrades.
Living quarters, a jetpack, storage for personal vehicles, free minigun ammo. Ah, it's just... it's good. It's good, okay? Oh yeah, now we're talking. The CEO office, in my opinion, is the best property to buy in the game. Not only do you get storage for up to 30 cars
with the purchase of all applicable upgrades,
you also get the ability to run not one, but two businesses. One of them being my personal choice for earning money legitimately and not just... yeah. You also get access to a large selection of your Pegasus vehicles, most of which are a pain to spawn if you don't own one of these due to how unreliable Pegasus is. And then there's the most important thing about owning an office. Free food!
All you can eat.
All you can eat?
So yeah, that's my personal list of the worst to the best properties to own in GTA Online. I'd be interested to see how you guys in the comments would rank them. Let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for loads more videos coming to you very soon. See you around, folks.